and Hannah here. So it's a lovely Thursday. Probably won't be Thursday when you see this video, but oh well. And I have one more day to go before the school holidays finish, which means one more school holiday horse riding camp to do. And then my week sort of goes back to normal again. So today is my day off from work. So I'm at the adjustment. I'm going to go and ride Duke, check, see how he is and all that sort of thing. And I'm very excited today, actually. I don't know, I feel just very motivated and very uplifted today. I just realised that I'm meant to be going to Melbourne to the dressage stable at the end of September, and that's coming up very quickly. Plus, my birthday's in August. And yeah, so everything's coming really quickly and it's really exciting. And today I think, you know, I don't know, I just can't explain it. Like, I'm just really, really happy. So today, the plan for today is obviously to ride Duke. And what I want to play around with is I don't really have a good understanding of how you use your seat. Like, I know I'm not meant to use my rein, like, to stop and all that sort of thing. And they always say, ride with your seat, not with your hand. But I ride a lot with my hand, and a lot of it is just because I'm not 100% sure how to not use my hand, if that makes sense. But I was pretty much watching someone else's vlog, and they were talking about seat. And they were talking about when you ride, you want to make sure you're sitting on your seat bones and make sure your butt isn't sticking out with a hollow back. And when you want a half halt, or you're going to ask for a bit more collection, you want to think about pushing your pelvis forward a little bit. I don't know if that makes sense. I might have to show you guys a bit later on when I come home. So I don't know. I'm going to have a bit of a play around with that. And I know when I was in Melbourne, the one thing I do, I need to reread my notes from when I was last in Melbourne at the stables. But I remember when I was there last, for example, with the, you know, trot, or, you know, with my hips or whatever, if I wanted to slow down, they said, well, don't go with the horse, slow your rhythm down. Ride smaller and slower to bring them back. So, I don't know, I think my plan today is to try and use a lot more of my seat with Duke today. And, yeah. So, let's go get Duke and let's get this day started.
Tonight, what's the dealio? I love when it's all too much. 5 a.m., turn the radio up. Where's the rock and roll? Body crasher, penny snatcher. Call me up if you a gangster. Don't be fancy, just get dancy. Why so serious? So raise your glass if you are.
Walking back, about to put Duke back in the paddock, and oh, we had such a good ride. It was so good. I was trying to sort of work on using my seat to sort of ask him to sort of engage his hindquarters a bit more, to sort of I guess to start asking for a bit of collection. We're doing a lot of that at the canter because I, for my benefit, I find it a bit easier to use my seat a bit better at the canter. So I thought I'll do it at the canter so that I can try and learn to get the feel of it. And oh, I'm so proud of him. He did such a good job. Didn't you? Yes. Yes, he did. So proud of him. So yeah, I'm going to put him back, hop in the car, come home, and I will speak to you guys then. All right. Hey guys, so I'm back home. So I've just had some lunch, peanut butter and tomato. Not the healthiest, but I really enjoy that. It's like brings back childhood memories. When my parents, my mum used to make me like, you know, peanut butter on a sandwich and then put tomatoes on it and I'd eat it. Yum. Anyways, I guess I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about sort of my ride today on Duke. So I told you guys in the clip before that I was really, really happy with him. So because I've been working this week, he's only been worked on Monday and then today. So he's only worked twice this week, just the same as last week. Anyway, today, because I was said to you before that I'm trying to sort of work out how to use my seat, and this is something still that I'm still sort of, you know, researching, trying to learn, and it's going to definitely be a hot topic when I go to Melbourne in 2 months, asking my coach, and sort of really trying to get this understanding, because at the moment, you know, I don't really have a complete understanding of how to use my seat to control the horse and all that sort of thing. But that's okay. That's exciting. It's part of my journey and I'm really excited to carry on. I'm really happy today. Sorry, just a random thought. Anyways, so what I learned from a fellow vlogger that I watched their YouTube channel, a video of part of their YouTube channel last night, and she was saying to use your seat, you have a neutral position and then you have a position where you sort of tip your pelvis forward, and that is what you do when you're asking a horse to half halt or you're trying to ask for more collection. So when I say collection, you know, I'm not meaning the horse is round and on the bit, because that's not collection. Collection is sort of when the horse puts their weight onto their hindquarters and their front end lifts up. So that's what I'm talking about when I say collection. And that's the top of the German training scale. So, you know, only horses pretty much at the very top levels have true collection or should have developed true collection. Anyway, so I thought, you know, I'll try that with Duke, and I did most of that work in the canter because in the canter, number one, I've got a bit more impulsion behind me because obviously there's a bit more push in the canter than there is in the walk. And then also because in the canter you sit, for me, trying to figure out how to use my seat, I found, you know, doing a gate where I can just sit in the saddle but have that more, that push and that impulsion behind me to help me a little bit, I could sort of play a little bit more around with my seat and experiment a little bit. And it paid off. So what I was doing with Duke, and it was just playing around. So I know if I want to create greater balance, I don't want to call it collection, because although that's what Duke's sort of developing, it's not true collection just yet. So I want to call it creating greater balance. If you think of riding horse like one of those old-fashioned scales, you know, where you sort of have, you know, that old-fashioned scales where you put one thing here, and it's sort of going to balance up, otherwise one's going to tip down more than the other. So if you think of a horse like that, when I say greater balance, so Duke is built on the forehand, so naturally, if this is his head, he's naturally going to be going around a bit more like this. Obviously over the years of working with Duke and riding, he's gotten stronger, so he's started to sort of lift up a little bit, but he's always been a little bit still, a bit more on the forehand. Now with creating the greater balance, which is what I did today, so what I was doing was putting him on a circle, because I know from what I've been taught in Melbourne, when you put them on a circle, that is an easier way to create greater balance or, you know, develop that collection, because the horse has to engage their hindquarters a lot more on the circle than they do on the straight.
So that's what I was doing. I was doing circles. And when I was on the circles, I was using a half halt with my reins. It's like a squeeze and release of my fingers. And then thinking about using, engaging my core and using that push of the tipping of the pelvis forward. And then also using my leg if I needed to sort of tell him, doesn't mean stop, just go, but come up a bit. And I was actually very surprised, but it actually worked, and Duke actually sort of I had the hang of that quite quickly. So he went from being slightly on the forehand, well, when he canters, he's really on the forehand. So from his canter being really on the forehand, he went up to pretty much being balanced. So obviously you want, in a dressage horse, their forehand to be up higher than their height. But for the moment, Duke was going around balanced. And I was really happy with that. For him to go around balance where at least he didn't feel like he was sort of dragging me forward, I thought that was a really good effort on his behalf. And I'm really sort of excited now, because I just sort of feel like I'm chipping away at this little puzzle about how to use my seat. And I had a bit of a win because it worked. Now, I'll try and video to sort of show you what I mean by the different seat positions. And again, don't quote me on this, I'm still learning myself. But, and I'm just sort of sharing you little bits and pieces that I sort of learn and uncover on the way. But let me move my chair out of the way and I'll see if I can show you. So, pretend I'm on my horse. So, what I realized, so we've all been told that when you ride, you want to feel like your butt bones are like connected to the saddle. And so that's what I first thought of when I first hopped on Duke today. Now, how I noticed I naturally want to ride is I want to sort of naturally ride with a bit of an arch in my back. Now, not this much, because that's a bit of an exaggeration of what I do, but some people ride like that, but just a little bit. Now, what that actually does is pushes your seat bones back a bit. And sorry, I'll bend down. And pretty much from what my understanding is, obviously, if it pushes your seat bones back, your seat bones are then not connected to the saddle, not connected to the horse, and therefore your seat is going to be ineffective. Now I'm going to show you what the neutral seat is. So what you should, you know, pretty much most of the time be sitting in, if you're not doing anything else with your seat. So we've got hollow back, I've got the arch. The neutral is I sort of tuck my bum underneath. So I don't know if you guys have ever heard about that imaginary line that goes from your ear, shoulder, hip and heel. Because I know when I was learning to ride, my coach was always like, oh, make sure if I was to draw an imaginary line, it should go from the middle of your ear, shoulder, hip and heel. And that's something I still teach my students, but it's only until literally today I've sort of realized you can't have that imaginary line if your bum isn't tucked underneath you. That was just like a bit of a gold moment right there. So that's your neutral seat. I'll show you again. So hollow back, tuck my bum under, neutral seat. I've got that line, ear, shoulder, hip, and heel. Now, if I want to tip my pelvis forward to ask for the collection of for a half halt, I'm not very good at it yet, but I will get there. What I'm going to do is push my hips forward. So not as, if I'm pushing my hips. So I'm going neutral, hips forward. It's a little bit weird, but hips forward and engage your core. I'm not the best at it, but that's what I was playing around with when I was riding Duke today. And well, it did something because I saw changes in his movement, and I was looking back on the video and you'll see some of it in today's clip. It was just so much better. It's just so, so much better. I'll see if I can maybe even add a clip of his canter work in other videos where he's very on the forehand, quite long in regards to his frame. Whereas today, it just seemed he was just a lot, looks much nicer, like more balanced and just more, he just looks a lot more with me, if that makes sense. We don't look so out of control in the canter, like we're just going for it, yeah? So that's what I'm playing around with. Very exciting when you learn new things. And the other thing I sort of learned about, because I don't know, core is something, you know, obviously as riders we need to develop and get stronger at and all that. And I was looking at another YouTube video last night for helping you to develop your core for horse riders. So more for dressage riders though. And what they were saying is, you know those big, like big blue, you know, not rubber, but plastic bouncy balls. They were saying, get one of those, sit on it with your legs out in front of you, and your legs should sort of be like 90 degrees to the ground. And when you're sitting there, lift one foot up slightly, like maybe a few inches off the ground. So just slightly off the ground, hold it for a few seconds, and then put it back down again and do it to the other one. Now, when you do it, you want to make sure you don't want to be like rocking on the ball from side to side. And I'll include a bit of a video. I'll show you what I mean, but I'm not very good at it. And basically what I was saying is it helps you to engage your core. So it teaches you to engage your core, helps you strengthen it a little bit, and also helps you with balance as well. And I tried it quickly as soon as I got home this afternoon, and because I think, oh, that seems pretty easy, but it's actually not. I was actually rocking so much and I was like, crap, I've got a lot of work to do. But that's okay. I feel like saying that's okay, it's like my phrase, but it is. It's just exciting to have things to work on. And oh, I'm just feeling so motivated. I can't wait for Melbourne in 2 months, and things are really cracking. I'll go and show you that now. Hey guys, so just before I conclude this vlog, I thought I'd give you guys a little bit of an update on selling Duke. So my home coach has a student who's possibly interested in Duke. So I'm just going to wait and see how that plays out. And I'll let you guys know how it goes. But yeah, otherwise, I haven't quite found him a home just yet. And as I've said previously, I'm not going to just, you know, hurry up and give him, you know, sell him to just anyone. I just want to make sure he's going to have the best future possible, because I do love him. He's a very special horse to me. It's because of him, you know, I've found my passion for dressage, and it's pretty much just because of him I'm now on this journey. So he does deserve the best next home. Anyway, I'll keep you guys updated on that front. But yeah, that just concludes my vlog for today. The next vlog you'll see will be next week, and I'll actually be vlogging at a dressage competition. So I'm going to a dressage competition in Kellert to watch the high level dressage tests. So anything from like novice up, I'm pretty much going to go and watch. So that'll be very exciting. And yeah, and I'll see you guys next week. So yeah, so if you guys enjoyed this video, please remember to like my video on like the icon down below the video. And please also remember to subscribe to my channel so that you guys never miss an episode. And I'll see you guys next week. Bye.